What is meditation? How do you do it? And why should you bother? Meditation is the art of giving your full attention to something other than your busy mind. It reliably brings calm and clarity. And it's probably the best free, no-tech life hack ever discovered. Scientific studies have shown that meditation has broad benefits, not just for the mind, but for the whole body. The Buddha taught a meditation method in ancient India that has come to be called mindfulness meditation. It involves sitting still and resting your attention on your breathing. You sit with legs crossed in front, using a firm cushion to lift your hips off the floor. It helps if the cushion is slightly wedge-shaped to tilt your pelvis gently forward. Your legs are crossed loosely, with your feet resting on the floor. You also can try half or full lotus with one or both feet tucked on top of the opposite thigh, but these more difficult poses aren't necessary. Another sitting style, often used by Zen monks, is a kneeling pose with your legs straddling a cushion that supports your hips. For this, you'll want a thick cushion, and it should not be wedge-shaped, or you can just sit on a chair. But if it's not uncomfortable for you, sitting on the floor is preferable because it gives you a more grounded feel, and it's better for your posture. Posture is critical. Keep an erect spine with head balanced atop your neck, chin gently tucked, shoulders relaxed, and push slightly back to open the chest with your arms at rest. Let your spine feel elongated and uplifted, with all the vertebrae stacked like coins in stable alignment. Slumping kills meditation. What do you do with your hands? There are three traditional hand placements. Rest your hands, palms down, on your thighs, or rest them, palms up, on your thighs, with the tips of the thumbs and index fingers touching, and the other three fingers lying flat. Or rest your hands, palms up, in your lap, with the right hand on top of the left, and the thumb tips touching each other. Either softly close your eyes or leave them open, gazing downward with a soft focus on the floor about 6 feet in front of you. Studies have shown that the way you pose your body directly affects your emotions. So when you sit to meditate, sit nobly, with your whole body poised and uplifted. Meditation is focusing on something other than your noisy mind. Buddha taught to rest your awareness on your breath in a relaxed, unstrained focus. Respiration is the perfect flow to concentrate upon, the ongoing rhythm that keeps you alive. Regard each breath as a gift and give it your full attention in a mood of reception and gratitude. You'll notice that your breathing slows and deepens all by itself. Where exactly should you place your attention on the breath? Traditionally, two locations are recommended. Find out which one feels more natural for you. Either concentrate on the air moving in and out at the very tip of the nostrils, cool air in, warm air out, or focus at the base of the diaphragm as it sinks and rises. Keep your spine elongated and stay tuned to your breath. You'll begin to settle more and more fully into the present moment, the right here and right now of real life. As a popular Buddhist teacher, Thich Nhat Hanh, puts it, breathing in, know you are breathing in. Breathing out, know you are breathing out. Present moment, only moment. To be sure, while you're sitting in keen awareness of your breathing, sensations will still occur. Emotions and thoughts will pop up like rabbits from wherever they hide. But this is not a rabbit chase. You simply acknowledge them, but don't pursue them. In Buddhism, the metaphor of the open sky is used to describe the natural spaciousness of awareness. You awaken to this inherent openness. You are being this spaciousness by not reacting to every tingle or memory that passes through. What you want to avoid is getting into a war with anything that comes up in meditation. So when you get distracted, just gently return your awareness to your flowing breath, in and out, in and out. What won't work is a militant attitude that you're going to conquer your wandering mind. That's like commanding your mind not to think of a penguin. See the problem? For novice meditators, training wheels are available. If you find your internal commotion too distracting, give your mind something to do. Try counting each breath. One, two, one, two. If the mind needs a bigger task, count 1 through 10, then back to 1. Over and over. How long should each meditation session last? 10 minutes is enough for beginners. And yes, you should set a timer. The thing is, because we've all gotten used to nearly constant stimulation from screens, big and small, sitting quietly for 10 minutes will at first feel like an hour. Yet, with experience, you'll grow to appreciate each sitting as a little vacation. A common meditation practice is 20 minutes, twice a day. You'll soon notice the benefits. Back in the 1960s, Herbert Benson, a cardiologist and professor of mind-body medicine at Harvard Medical School, found that meditation, which he called the relaxation response, significantly reduces stress, promoting the opposite of the fight-or-flight response. In the 1970s, researchers scanned the brains of Buddhist monks and recorded high levels of activation in the brain areas that control focus and positive emotions. More recently, Richard Davidson, a neurologist at the University of Wisconsin, found that experienced meditators produce more gamma brainwaves, which are linked to lucid thinking. But what about beginner meditators? How long does it take to reap results? Sarah Lazar, a Harvard neuroscientist, published two studies. Volunteers with little or no meditation experience took an 8-week mindfulness meditation course. The novice meditators reported feeling less stressed overall. And what's more, meditating had reshaped the physical structure of their brains. The brains had grown larger in areas that affect learning, memory, and emotion, and had shrunken in the area that controls reaction to threat. The opposite happens in brains that undergo chronic stress. According to a guide printed by Prevention magazine, studies have shown positive effects on mood and pain after 5 to 10 minutes per day for 3 or 4 days. Let's not look at this ancient meditation method as if it were a fad diet, something you try for 6 weeks before switching to the Oreos and milk diet. Better to regard mindfulness meditation as one element in a new lifestyle, the mindfulness lifestyle. That's what the Buddha had in mind. Practicing right now, bringing your full attention to this present moment.